got one club to tie in, John's from, we've heard from him before, so he forgot probably all know him, but I'll let him introduce himself one more time.
Go ahead, John.
Here, this guy from outside.
Okay.
This is actually the older one, this is getting a little tired, and the reason it's old is, since we made this one, we've taken in the upper swamp, revert it's on here.
Will change the name?
John.
I also know you, but just for the notes, could you just real quickly just introduce yourself, kind of maybe mention who Walls is?
I will. I'm Johnson Waterman, I'm president of Walls Watershed Coalition. The acronym, yeah, that's the name of the Walls Watershed Coalition, the acronym stands for Withlacoochee, Willacoochee, Alaska, Upper Suwannee. Their system, we define the S.
Yeah, there you go.
Withlacoochee, Willacoochee.
No, the S, what was the S?
System. We did that deliberately, the placeholder. And we didn't wanna do it start with because we had enough to do just to get started, but 3 years later, it seemed time. Plus, we're having a lot of issues now in Florida we had to deal with. And we are, of course, the water system that crosses the state line. Speaking of which, are y'all aware of the salinity study that Florida Department of Environmental Protection did? I can send you the preliminary maps that we got from them, and they're quite impressive. I'm not sure Miami actually has fresh water anymore. And there's salts and other dissolved solids coming up in wells right up to the state line, south of where we are. So it might be something I want to look at. The coast of the state line is probably not stopping there.
That's groundwater study, John.
Yes.
Could you send that?
Who should I send it to?
You send that to?
You send it to me.
I'll send that to Shane.
Okay.
I've asked her, so, well, pretty close to here. With an ice and ice and ice cameras.
And I've done maps for the whole state and each of their water management districts, so I'll see where all that is. Another thing that crosses, I'm not sure that one crosses the state line, but another thing that certainly crosses the state line, we're talking about more land in irrigation. Are you aware of the purchases from West Coast investors recently? Recently, as in the last 2 or 3 years, in Lanier, Eccles, Lyons County, Georgia, West, Mountain, Swan County, Florida. One of the purchasers' names you probably heard of, Bill Gates. And he's done things in Hamilton County like clear cut in areas that you could say that then he was immediately becoming organic agriculture. And he's fertilizing using chicken manure, which is kind of interesting when you think about where most of that chicken manure comes from and how much arsenic and other stuff is in there. Might be something you might want to think about looking into and plan. We have some information as well, which I'll be happy to send you and forward to come along. He's not the only one that's making these purchases. There's at least one other West Coast investor from the California Central Valley. And it's not just about watershed, it's also on top of it. He's bought up, Gates in particular, bought up 250,000 acres nationwide. We're trying to find out what he's going to do. Anyway, speaking of underground water flow, which I think I heard mentioned, two things. I don't know if I heard mentioned that a lot of the water flow apparently comes from the northwest and southeast, in other words, from the Flint area of the river. So I'm glad to hear you're coordinating with Flint. Another thing, this is very recent. Waycross cancer clusters clustering around wells. With underground water flow apparently going from the CSX rail yard to the wells and there on into east that direction, into the left of Swanee, this is where CSX. CSX is well-known carrier radioactive materials. And there's a company called EOC, which stands for British Oxygen Company. It's known as EOC. It does radioactive gases as far as what it does. Nobody knows, but it's something that a lot of people are looking at to stay healthy. That was mostly what I wanted to talk about. Oh, yes. A topic I've mentioned before, speaking of Florida and Georgia, the Sabre Trail natural gas pipeline. If you listen to Sabre Trail, they'll have you think that that's all that deal. They got all the permits, but they do not. There's at least two Georgia permits still outstanding, one of which might just not be an issue this year, and one in Florida. U.S. Army Corps of Engineers has not issued a permit and does not normally do that until all the state permits are issued. So there's still time if you should feel an inclination to write to the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. I'll send these addresses. Any good luck?
Sorry, John, I missed that. What was it in regards to?
The Sable Trail.
Sable?
S-A-B-A-L pipeline.
Yes, gotcha.
The project is Spectrum Energy in Texas, FPO, Florida, and Duke Energy in North Carolina, so no benefit to Georgia. And other than that, I'm happy to see you all back in business and doing good work again.
Yeah, we should be back most of the year. We have more than people to watch, so check the website.
All right, and also I should invite you to notice on the back of this newsletter, there's a number of outings coming up. Feel free to come along and paddle with us.
Sounds good. Appreciate you coming, John.
Probably good to see you.
Since our crowd's been out, that pretty much does it for the public comments. We'll move on into the wrap up and the council meeting to preview. We're ahead, but I'd like to stay ahead.
I think we can do that. All right, so the next meeting,